raised concerns about the future of SpaceX's ambitious endeavors. Is SpaceX in trouble? We'll be diving into this problem and more in today's episode of Science of Space. The South Pole of the Moon is a breathtaking place, with towering mountains bathed in perpetual sunshine and lunar dust that gleams like fine powder in unfiltered light. Plunging craters exist in permanent shadows, hiding pockets of ice in their gray rock, water that has been frozen and undisturbed for as long as 3 billion years. NASA had plans to land a new crew of astronauts on this silent terrain, but the Lunar Starship isn't happening anytime soon and could be delayed even longer. Speaking at a recent briefing, Jim Free, NASA's Associate Minister of Exploration Systems Development, said that the Artemis 3 mission still has a formal launch date of December 2025, but he was monitoring potential delays in hardware needed for the mission. Back in June, concerns were expressed about the delayed debut of Starship, and worries about the operational aspects of the lunar lander. However, NASA has contingency plans for every possible scenario. If there are delays with Starship, they'll have equivalent missions prepared as potential replacements. The essence of Artemis 3 could be influenced by the outcomes and progress of Artemis 2. Indeed, SpaceX's version of Starship, under contract with NASA, is responsible for lunar orbit and transferring astronauts from the Orion spacecraft to the lunar surface and back. It's a complex process, but NASA is determined to make it happen. Stay tuned for more updates on this exciting and challenging mission. NASA is on a mission to reach the moon once again, but this time they're aiming for a more permanent presence. The Artemis program is their ambitious plan to establish a sustainable lunar exploration program, and it all hinges on the success of their HLS rocket and Orion capsule. However, recent progress updates have left some concerned about the timeline for the Artemis 2 mission. The Orion capsule, which will carry astronauts to and from the moon, is still undergoing finalization and investigations into its heat shield could potentially delay the lunar journey. Meanwhile, the assembly of the HLS rocket has also been delayed due to unspecified issues with its downcomers. It's clear that the project isn't quite ready for NASA's Artemis 2 launch schedule. But even if Artemis 2 is delayed, the bigger question is whether the Orion spacecraft and HLS rocket will be ready in time for Artemis 3. SpaceX, who is also working on the Artemis program, has their own set of challenges to overcome. They need to launch multiple times before they can meet the requirements of the mission, and NASA is hoping for their success in these launches. One of the most exciting aspects of the Artemis program is the use of Starship, SpaceX's next-generation spacecraft. But before humans can board, there are several milestones that need to be met. First, there needs to be a successful ship-to-ship transfer from a fuel depot spacecraft to Starship. Then, Starship needs to perform a successful uncrewed landing on the moon. Only then can NASA proceed with sending astronauts on board. However, NASA is also concerned about potential delays in the development of the Axiom spacesuit, which can only be designed once Starship is completed. Any delays in either the spacesuits or Starship could lead to a reordering of missions. Despite these challenges, NASA and SpaceX remain optimistic. The first orbital launch of Starship may not have gone as planned, but it served as a significant stepping stone for the development of the spacecraft. NASA was able to see the most challenging technologies that Starship will execute beyond space, during their recent visit to the star base. With a leading aerospace company like SpaceX on their side, NASA is confident that they can overcome any obstacles and reach their goal of establishing a sustainable lunar exploration program. The field of space exploration is brimming with potential and progress, thanks to SpaceX's tireless efforts. Despite NASA's reservations about the Starship, it's worth considering whether their skepticism is genuine or a cover-up for their own issues and delays. The HLS's funding and instability, as well as the Orion capsule, could further postpone the moon's return. However, SpaceX is making significant headway in preparing for the second Starship launch. They've developed a massive water deluge system, a more robust launch pad, and addressed challenges from the initial launch by modifying the rocket. These issues aren't significant for SpaceX, as they continue to achieve milestones. Exciting discoveries have emerged, such as an image of the nose cone labeled HLS, with a human-sized door on the left side, indicating the emergence of a life support system. Although SpaceX hasn't confirmed this information, the potential for parallel development is remarkable. If the Starship launches successfully this year, The likelihood of a successful HLS mission by 2024 is high, possibly even by mid-year instead of the end of the year as suggested by NASA. It's crucial for the Biden administration and Congress to support and endorse this project, as their support could enhance the Starship's development process. The Starship holds immense potential to unlock a future, filled with endless possibilities in space exploration. With SpaceX's unwavering determination and the support of key stakeholders, it won't be long until we witness the remarkable achievements that the Starship will bring to the world. The role of the moonbound Starship takes on a whole new level of significance in the thrilling race to the moon between the United States and China. While there may be differing opinions on whether this race is truly happening, the use of such terminology by prominent U.S. politicians, including NASA Administrator Bill Nelson, in its widespread coverage in global media strongly suggests that many perceive this competition as real. And why wouldn't they? If China manages to land humans on the moon before the U.S., they could assert their dominance and claim it as their own, just as they did with the South China Sea. This would undoubtedly be seen as a powerful statement of China's position as a global leader, and a testament to the capabilities of their communist government. China's ambitions in space are undeniably substantial. While the United States actively seeks to rally nations to join the Artemis Accords, an agreement promoting peaceful and collaborative international space exploration, China stands as an exception among the 28 nations that have endorsed these accords. This highlights China's independent stance and their clear aim to dominate the moon for their own interests. But what makes the moon so enticing? Well, aside from its inherent mystique, the moon holds a valuable resource in the form of trapped water ice, particularly in the lunar South Pole. This is why the competition for lunar exploration has reached unprecedented levels of intensity. Unlike the well-lit landing sites of Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin, photographs of the South Pole reveal a landscape dotted with deep craters perpetually cast in shadows due to the angle of the sun. These shadowed craters hold layers of hidden ice, which could prove to be a game changer. This ice holds significant promise as a crucial resource for both rocket fuel production and essential drinking water. Bill Nelson, the NASA administrator, emphasizes the importance of the international community's interests in this pursuit. If we indeed find an abundance of water on the moon, it could be utilized for future space missions, providing a vital resource for both crew and spacecraft. The implications of such a discovery are immense, and the race to uncover these hidden treasures intensifies with each passing day. So, as the moonbound Starship takes center stage in this captivating race, the world watches with bated breath. Will the US or China be the first to claim victory? The answer holds not only scientific and technological significance, but also geopolitical implications. The moon has become the ultimate symbol of power and dominance, and the stakes have never been higher. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.